St. John's Wort is a Japanese horror movie that attempts to mimic too many movie styles and genres and ends up missing the mark entirely. Not only does the movie stick too closely to the conventions that we've seen and doesn't really mix things up or do a lot that's interesting, but it also is missing a lot of the elements that makes camcorder or haunted house movies truly excellent. So what could have been a very well done haunted house movie, stylistic picture, or perhaps even a story-driven thriller, ends up being a mix of the three without really succeeding in any given category. The movie begins with a game designer team working on a new horror movie adventure game. Character designer Nami recently inherited a property that once belonged to her father. And Nami, not knowing much about her family history, she decides to take one of her male friends along with her so that they can explore the small mansion. And with this comes a lot of slow exploration and small bits of story thrown in throughout the movie. Much of the movie is shown through Nami's friend's handheld camera and other cameras that are secured around different areas of the house. Typically, haunted house movies are great at throwing cheap jump scare tactics at the viewer to keep them engaged. Since jump scares can get a little annoying, I was happy to see that St. John's Wort avoided this crutch. However, it doesn't really do much better because the scenes of exploration in the movie are pretty boring. It's just a lot of characters shining their light over here or there, or opening this, or moving that from here to there. Like, although jump scares can get rather annoying, they're certainly better than no scares. Like, perhaps with the right tension level built, or knowing more about the story, these scenes could have actually been scarier. But what ends up happening is that there is an eventual payoff, but viewers may find themselves drifting in and out at times. Once there are more plot points that come into the picture, such as a character named Naomi, Nami's father, and discoveries of cases involving missing children, the movie begins to allow the viewer's mind to wander, and that's definitely a good thing. The combination of these plot elements are great, but it does sort of fall into the category of too little, too late, you know, as my interest was piqued for only the last 25 minutes or so of the film. The movie does tend to keep most of these questions unanswered, which really did disappoint me. Finding out more about Nami's father and the missing children would have added so much more to the film. And while I did acknowledge that there is a payoff in the film, it's not a very big one, because like I said, since there's so many unanswered questions, the payoff in the film would just be that, you know, those last 25 minutes or so of the movie would be very interesting. And while there are interesting things happening, it doesn't really get too scary. It doesn't really reach the height that I've seen a lot of movies, you know, when they reach their climax. And it's a shame because I really think that this movie did have that potential. St. John's Wort ends up being a movie that I could possibly give a very mild recommendation to, or in most cases, not a recommendation at all, because it's definitely not something that I would rush out to watch or rewatch several times. And just because with this movie trying to mimic a lot of other horror movies that have already come out, not only does it not break any new mold, but yeah, it doesn't really even mimic what makes these movies successful in a very interesting way. And that's too bad because there are a few stylistic effects towards the beginning of the movie, like some scenes with some flowers that are interesting, and you know, this movie does have that hidden potential there, but there are just so many better movies that have come out of Japan specifically, or just Asia in general, that deserve people's time. So this one you can definitely skip.